Hola amigos, welcome back to my channel. In my last episode, I talked about Wi-Fi and data SIM card in Cuba. Today, I'm gonna talk about offline map and I will show you how to use it. During my trip in Cuba, I used Mapsme as my offline map. I didn't like it at the beginning because it looks very different from Google Map, but actually it's not that bad, so let's go through it together. I'm using a Samsung phone with Android system. Before going to your trip, first download the app Mapsme, open the app and search the country that you're going to. I'm using Cuba here. I type Cuba and click download map. It takes a few minutes, so let's fast forward. Once it's done, click show map. I'm going to Havana, so I just enlarged the map on Havana. If you can't see the location that you want, just search it. When you use Mapsme, remember to turn on the GPS. If you have data on your phone, you can turn it off at this moment to save your data. You see the blue arrow that was my location when recording the screen. I was in my Airbnb, but it showed that I was at an intersection. So I clicked on another accommodation that's close to mine and bookmarked it. So I know where I live. Then I searched National Capital, which is a very important landmark in Havana. Again, I bookmarked it. Then I click Route 2. It will show the route from my current location to National Capital. But that's the route for car, so I have to click the person icon next to it. When you walk, the GPS arrow will follow. I have used many times, so it's quite accurate. Now I search a restaurant named San Cristobal. I want to see if I can walk there after visiting National Capital. So again, I search and bookmarked it. Now I click on the bookmark icon of National Capital. You can choose route from or route to, because National Capital is my starting point. So I choose route from, then type San Cristobal, which is the destination I want to go. It will show you the route and time. That's how I use Mapsme when I was in Cuba. Google Map is also available for offline, but it only has the route for driving. When I was in Havana, I tried to look for a gym. I searched from both Google Map and Mapsme. There were three or four, but finally only one exists. If you're looking for non-touristic places, it's better to ask the local. Okay, that's it for me. In my next episode, I'm going to share my cost of living in Havana. So stay tuned. I'll see you next time. Bye.